Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Bellistic Sportsdesk. Pat Gonsalves, along with the 2022 Corduroy Enduro official photographer, Andy Wilson. And Andy, today we want to talk a little bit about all of the places you visited and all of the images you captured over 4 days. I think next to Blair, Sharpless, you were probably the busiest guy in the Halliburton Highlands that weekend.
Well, I don't know about that, but I definitely had my work cut out for me. I showed up, I think, Wednesday night and started shooting Thursday. We started off with some demo rides. I even got to ride a couple bikes myself, but I think it was beautiful weather Thursday, and we managed to get some good pictures. Yeah, and then we moved on to the Friday. Friday, we got the vintage class and the e-bikes, which was really cool.
It was first time shooting e-bikes?
Yeah, that was, and it was very interesting. It was cool to see. Wasn't much to hear, but got some cool pictures, I think, of that. And yeah, I think that was a really cool feature to have.
And then what about some of the areas away? What is sort of your photography style?
Well, I'm a rider, so I like to take pictures that I would want to be in myself. So when I try to set up a shot, I just think of what I want to see. Like if I was riding, what I'd want to see. That's kind of how I set up my shots. So if there's like a big berm turn or, you know, some nice like scenic woods shots or something like that, that's what I like to shoot.
Yeah. Now you've been there before, and going into the weekend, do you predetermine what tests you're going to go to and sort of lay out a game plan for both days?
I definitely have an idea of what I want to shoot. I know some of the features of the cord. It does change every year, so it keeps you on your toes. But I definitely have an idea of some of the stuff that I want to shoot. And I shot last year. I showed up and I shot the race, and I wanted to get different shots than last year. I try not to take all the same shots, but some of my favorites this year was definitely the Tunnel of Love. I was right in the tunnel for that, which was pretty crazy. And yeah, some of the water features, like the Burnt River crossing, that was really cool to shoot. That's a very big water crossing, so it made for some really interesting shots.
And for those people who've maybe been on YouTube, I know you've got a YouTube channel, Andy Wilson 89. You also have your website. That's where they can really delve into all of the various images that you captured on the weekend. I believe there are almost 700 images that you took over the 4 days that are currently posted on your website.
Yeah, I like to try and shoot as many people as possible. It's a lot of work editing and posting all those shots, but I like to try and give everyone a fair chance. I was shooting for KTM and Yamaha this year, so I was obligated to shoot their riders. I think last year I was able to shoot up to row 40 or so. This year was about row 23 where Russell was. He was the last pro rider that I was supposed to shoot, so I wasn't able to shoot as many riders this year, but I tried my best and I posted all the shots that I got.
Yeah, one of my favorite images, having attended the cord for a few years now, is that Sunday morning with the hundreds of motorcycles in the impound area over top of that ball diamond that serves as the impound. Are there a few of those, some gems either from the previous year or this year?
That's one of my favorite shots to get, is the bikes in the impound, and we always seem to get really nice weather on the Sunday morning. I think the last 2 years we had some really nice fog during the sunrise, and that makes for some incredible pictures with all those bikes lined up beside each other. This year I got a couple drone shots and a couple stills, but that's definitely a great place to take some pictures, and it's also good to get photos of the riders working on their bikes in the morning.
Yeah. Now, you're not only a professional photographer, but as you mentioned earlier, you're a longtime motorcyclist, and you've got a big trip planned. I'll call it a road trip, but it's a lot of roads, starting in the United States, going through Mexico, Central America, and even making your way down into South America. How long has that been in the plans, and what can people look for on your website and on your YouTube channel, I guess starting at the end of October when you'll be leaving Ontario?
Yeah, so that trip's been in the works for a while. At first, it wasn't going to be a motorcycle trip. But recently I decided I'm going to just go out on my bike. I've been riding for more than 20 years. I've raced the pro class here in Ontario, and I just decided that I need to get out on my bike and explore the world a bit. So I'm definitely excited to go out and do that. I'm going to be bringing my camera. I'll be taking a lot of stills, and I do plan on vlogging the whole thing. So my plan is to release a video once a week or so, and just update everyone where I am and show some of the riding and the cool locations that I'm going to.
Well, it sounds like you've got a film in the making. Will you be, as the song goes, home for Christmas?
I am not sure where I'm going to be for Christmas this year. I don't have a route planned out. I don't have a timeline either. I'm hoping to be out for at least a year.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's going to be a heck of an adventure. I'm just basically going to go where the weather's nice and where the wind blows me. So, it should be an incredible adventure, and I'm really excited to share it with everyone.
Well, hopefully you're back in time for the 2023 Cord. Are there a few, or maybe one or two specific images that you took over the 4 days that, are sort of among your selects?
Yeah, I think some of the tunnel pictures are my favorite this year. It filled up with the two-stroke smoke, and I got a couple shots of some riders coming out of the smoke, and I think they're my favorite shots. I also got some really good berm shots of Ryder Heacock and Owen McKill blowing up the sand berms right at the community center there. Those, I think, are right up there in my favorites as well.
Well, Andy, we thank you for sitting in on the Bellistic Sports Desk. Again, andywilsonmedia.com is the website to check out almost 700 images of the 2022 Promation Corduroy Enduro presented by GP Bikes. You can also follow Andy's adventures on his KTM motorcycle as he travels through the U.S., Mexico, Central, and South America. That'll wrap up this edition of the Bellistic Sports Desk. And again, our 2023 Promation Corduroy Enduro presented by GP Bikes coming up September 21 to 24, 2023.
Hey!
Awesome!
Right. Okay. Awesome!
Thanks, Andy. All the best, man.